let's talk about the best vitamin for emotional instability. Now, there are other causes of emotional instability that have nothing to do with your nutrition. I'm going to talk about the nutrient connection to your emotions. It's a deficiency of vitamin B1. If you're deficient in B1, you may experience emotional instability and delirium. What is that? It's mental confusion and emotional disruption, which also occurs frequently when an alcoholic is going through withdrawal symptoms, or even a drug addict goes through these withdrawal symptoms. Now, there are certain specific parts of your brain that require vitamin B1. Here they are, the hippocampus, which has a lot to do with your memory and also like a relay switch with your emotions. The amygdala, which has a lot to do with stress responses, very similar to the adrenal, but in your brain, needs B1 because, of course, stress depletes B1. And the mammillary bodies, which are two structures in the brain, which not only can influence emotions, but also spatial memory, your ability to remember where locations are in time and space. So let's say, for example, you have a hard time finding some location because you don't have a GPS, you don't have a map, and someone told you where to go, and you're like, I'm not sure how to get there. That's a problem with the mammillary body. So these three structures need a lot of B1 to function. Another interesting thing is when you electrically stimulate nerves within these structures, they give off a high rate of vitamin B1, 80 times more than resting nerves. The more that you're using these structures, the more B1 is necessary. The RDAs for B1 is only 2 milligrams. B1 is water soluble, so you don't really store a lot of it. And your body needs a small amount of it, but it needs it consistently. So if you're consuming a lot of glucose, or you go through a lot of stress, or a lot of refined foods, or even chlorine, that can also deplete your B1. Now, your B1 needs also depend on the amount of carbohydrates. The more carbohydrates, the more sugar you're consuming, the more B1 that you're going to need. Now, what's really wild is like potassium. You need 4,700 milligrams. And B1, you only need 2 milligrams. So again, you don't need much, but you need it consistently. Other symptoms that a B1 deficiency will create would be irritability, depression, anxiety, confusion, memory loss, lack of initiative, poor ability to learn, and poor concentration. The best source of B1 is nutritional yeast. If you're going to buy a B1 supplement, I highly recommend you don't buy a synthetic version. You get a natural version. But if you get an unfortified or unenriched nutritional yeast, that will have enough B1. All right, thanks for watching.
Hey, we're back
with another amazing recipe.
No grains, no sugar, totally keto. There's no suffering in keto.
Absolutely not, Karen.
And it's an immune system builder.
Absolutely. You have to check this out.
I think you should hurry up, watch the recipe, and make it yourself. It's just so easy to be keto.
But is it simple?
It's super simple. We hope you enjoy making it as much as we are enjoying eating it.